And welcome to another episode of Open Source Live Code Hangout. We're working on the Western Friend website. I've got a pull request in progress. So if you're tuning into this live stream after the fact and you would just like to see what we did, you can jump straight here to this pull request number 907. Where we're working on online payments. When we left off, we have a PayPal button here, and when I submit this button, it activates a PayPal processing flow. And I need to get my credentials over here. My sandbox credentials. One moment. So basically, this is a sandbox user, and I'll get the password. It's a personal sandbox account, make believe. We go through a regular PayPal payment flow here. And when I complete this purchase, we're directed back to my site. In other words, to the order capture URL. Payment books to order one, capture. And we're getting capture books to order payment, got multiple values for the argument order ID, which is right here, this order ID. So I gotta figure out what I'm doing wrong here. And if I can, how I can debug this. Because basically this is an internal error. I'm not getting much information there. And from on the surface of this error, this is a single value and it maps directly to my URL here. That's the problem. Okay, cool. It's just how I define my view. I'm not used to function-based views. Yeah, that makes sense. All right, good. All right, so we get the request as the first argument. Okay, fix that. And essentially now what I can do is go to the next error. Store one capture cannot resolve get object or 404. Line 234. All right, that's no problem. So it's just ID. Okay, because we're grabbing an order by ID. All right, so little bugs here and there. JSON decoder, PayPal capture order, response JSON. All right. So this is in our PayPal Python. Oh man. So hopefully that fixed that. Excuse me. All right, now it's behaving as we expected. It's handling the exceptions. So some errors happening. And this could be that I've captured the payment multiple times. And I will try logging into my PayPal sandbox to see if it captured any errors or exceptions. From the business perspective, it doesn't really give me much. From the developer perspective, maybe I'll have some errors. So what I'll try to do just real quick is go back through the bookstore, add to cart. I've got an item in the cart. I'll create a new order. Creating that order should succeed. And I can take these out of the templates. We're now in order ID 2, and we're gonna try to capture the payment for that as soon as I complete the PayPal authorization flow. Yeah. Let's try it again. That's the business user. Logging in. Payment was canceled. All right. All right. So this was just auto-generated by ChatGPT. Create order. Capture the payment. Check out ordered ID authorize. So we got, oh man, where'd it go? Yeah, update order. Confirm the order. Authorize payment. So we got our base URL. Because it's not just creating it. Now I think if we go back, payment was canceled, pay online. Let's see if this is valid. Still, perhaps it is. Redo checkout orders, 17. Processable entity. All right. Getting forward progress, forward progress. Path parameter ID, authorization. Content type. Processable entity. This could also be that I failed processing before, and so the order is somehow invalid now. So let's do order 3. Recipient, city. Processable entity. All right. I'm checking my logs over here. 422 error. The aggressive action could not be performed semantically incorrect or failed business validation. So it's not an authorization error. Order not approved. Order not approved. Payer has not yet approved the order for payment. Redirect the payer to the approve URL. Return as part of the HATE OS. OS links. This is so convoluted. So basically, in this create order, I need to now redirect in my view. Where's PayPal create order? Right here. I clearly don't understand this flow. I'm creating a PayPal order. Good God. And the documentation is just so shitty. The layout, I'm just getting kind of really frustrated with the PayPal developer experience here. Yeah, the flow, they had a diagram of this. It was yeah, it's this thing. It's really, what the hell? So here we have a checkout screen. Shows the button. And Stripe is just much more straightforward here in Braintree. All right, so essentially, in my checkout form. We need to just redirect here. Nothing in PayPal yet. All right. So I did that too early. No problem. We don't have, so we won't have PayPal ID yet. That makes sense. All right, all right, all right. Put all this here. So first we create the Western friend order. Then in our payment process bookstore order, here we go. Process bookstore payment. Right? That was it, I think. Different context, no longer necessary. Figure out to do that in a minute. Okay. Thank you. All right. So I just need JavaScript views essentially for all of this communication here. Man. I don't know, this is my probably misunderstanding here, but geez, this is just kind of a pain in the ass. Got that. This is what I don't understand. I've got an order creation. And order capture. Damn it. Create order, capture order. And this is just sort of mapping response, payload, and status code for use in the client. Checkout's pretty straightforward. Might go ahead and put this there. I'm not sure if that's something they manually did. Got your button. All right, so the button triggers order creation. Let's create some PayPal views here. That's essentially what it is, PayPal views. So, take a quick break, get a refresh of my beverage. I gotta think, reconsider this approach. Something's gotta give. Should be a lot simpler than I'm thinking. All right. Most of my data doesn't live in JavaScript. This is the bad assumption that everything lives in JavaScript, man. Thank you. So if I look at my processing script, I need to get this amount into the function. Okay. And I'll go back to the previous code where I handle a post inside of this. This create order function. Yeah, I can clear the cart later. So we can remove this. Since it's stored in this session. So I think now this will return to JSON, which should have order ID in there. We don't need this. We don't need this. We don't need this. I don't know if it should be before or after, and if the total cost should come from the cart or the order itself. Six or one, half of the dozen the other. Okay, okay. So let's see, now we're back in the process.js. Can you just do fetch current URL? That's not going to work. That'll work here. Thank you. This was incorrect. No, no, it's fine. So in this order create page, at this point, nothing PayPal should be going on. So this is mistaken here. Okay. Yeah. Yes, all right. Copy that in the wrong place. So save the form, create the cart items. That'll still be moved. We're not gonna clear this until payment success. Redirect payment process. I think that was pretty similar. So let's see if I can commit this. Orders views. Order views. Process bookstore order payment. That's true. I need to revert this change. Bit of linting, commenting. All right, commit this. Thank you. That's going to be necessary. And these will mostly be necessary. I can commit these a bit later. I believe we'll need the capture endpoint as part of this. That won't be necessary. Here we go. Now we're in the payment view. So this books or order payment is where we're at. All right, so let's hop over here. Payment views, yes, right here. All right, I'll take a quick break, grab some tea, use the restroom, and get things sorted. It looks like we've already got the PayPal logic here. I'm just gonna paste this in real quick again, just to double check it, so I don't forget all of that. But I believe it's kind of the same. I'm gonna try to capture that PayPal create order instead of capture the order. That's the distinction. Right now we should be first creating it and capturing it. We'll probably need JSON views for those. And that will encapsulate all of our logic in the PayPal library and allow our payment flow to the views, at least, not to have to even touch PayPal in the server side. Okay, I got it. All right, I'll be right back. All right, here we go. So I will need, come back to this in PayPal Pi. I'll create these PayPal views one more time. Thank you. Sounds good. It's a bit slow. I understand. Come back to this. I think the response is fine at this point. I don't need to. JSON encoded or anything. I'll figure out what I want to return here. Get a little bit of choice. A dictionary. Right now I'm returning JSON. Yeah. It might be that since I'm just operating at the API level here, I'm returning essentially a response JSON. Directly. Might not need to do that. Check this again. That's decimal. So capture bookstore order payment no longer needs to do this, but URLs here. That would have been nice if I could have done that. Not bad. And then in the core URLs, PayPal namespace, PayPal create order, PayPal capture order. So we'll need to edit our process.js and make sure we've got this. A template. PayPal create order. Western Front order ID, order ID. I don't have much in terms of error handling. This should be getter 404. It's going to be in the JavaScript. So. Exactly what it is. Get object or 404. Yeah, and I guess we can raise. I guess I can name my URLs a little bit differently. Well, let me think here for a second. This is all messed up right now. So basically, I'm going to delete all of this stuff, I think. I think we just don't need this whole thing. Strange. See. All right, that setting the app name. Let me double check in the PayPal. Yeah, that's there. I don't quite understand it then. But for example, payment, let me double check payment. Yeah, that's basically what I did. Really? Is resolving it. Leave the order ID there. But what I don't get is, did I use in the URLs for payment? Did I also place the app name there? Yeah. All right. PayPal. URLs, PayPal. I'm just going to name it, well, right. Okay. Hey Joel, thanks for the follow. How are you doing today? I'm posting to this so I could include that in the post, actually. Yeah, and in our JavaScript, I will be able to access. Fix my view real quick. Think we're not going to need this anymore. Think we can also do a kind of comment out this whole thing. And yeah, we don't need this anymore. I've been experimenting with that. I just cleared that up, clean that up there. I'll remove this. So we've got the PayPal amount, payment done URL and order, create URL. And yeah, we might need the order ID. So then in our JavaScript, key variables here. Yeah, but they're gonna current script. Sounds good. Right, I'll be right back. Take a small break, but I think we're making progress here. So I'll have the create order flow, then the approval flow, which we'll call our newly created capture function. And these are just gonna pass. They'll return JSON to the client. All right, I think I'm following the docs a bit closer now. I'll be right back. Excellent. So we'll do this approval one, which is, these are wrong now. It's call the capture URL. And then like on success. Yeah. Order capture URL, I do need to construct here. Pass that in too. So in my template, similar, it's like fetch. Like, the more of this I can do in the client, the better. So I think we're here. Huh. I don't want to have to be writing so much imperative JavaScript. This is... really unfortunate. So the order capture URL. Yeah, so the response will have a status and some other details. Right, I do need to fix my URLs here. Try it again. Thank you. Yeah. So it's returning a 403 forbidden template. Okay. Process. What the heck is toolbar JS? Is this debug toolbar? Okay, that's not it. Create order error, unexpected token. It's not valid JSON. Sandbox. All right. So this is coming from an HTML document. URL. I'm gonna make sure I can clear the cache. Let's just try this one step at a time. All right, so those look good. I think I've checked these all before, but let's check them again. Well, it's there, it's not correct, but yeah, we'll fix that. Thank you. views. All right. Three forbidden. Interesting. Now this is a browser. Let's try that. Son of a gun. Hey, doing a little bit better there. 500 error. I like that. All right, that's cool. It's very concrete. That's not working. That's not working. That's a string, though. Strange that I have to do this kind of thing with Django. It doesn't make quite sense. As bytes, okay. Well, it should be in JSON format. That's maybe what I'm confused about. Oops, wrong one. Let me double check here. All right, it should be there. Okay, getting a little bit different error. 422, unprocessable entity. Okay, this is unfortunate that it's taking so much dang time. I think this is just a matter of getting to start over here. Create a dang order. Check it out. Now we have some information. That was working before. I'm going to check the PayPal error log real quick. Huh, this is the strange part. Okay. So, I have a 201 success here with this order. For $23.95. Let me try this again with a different order value. Let's say three items. All right. I'll have to fix this. This is a strange here. Oh, that's not working. Yeah, I'm going to take a quick break before I submit this and read through the code one more time for this view handler. Be right back. Cool. What I want to do is just debug this. It's somewhere in here or here. So let's run and debug. You know, it could be anywhere along here, along the lines. Body JSON. So we get a request. It's got a body, but in bits, it's got the WF order. It's looking good to there. We'll continue. Then our body JSON, this is WF order ID. Correct, looking good. Now we're gonna fetch the order. We're still waiting. Now we've got order 7, so that's good. Aha, so let's hop into here real quick. Headers, response. Continue. We're gonna construct, we're gonna create this. Let me make sure that order has a get total cost. It's, I'm sure. It should be a string. Gonna return a decimal, we'll parse the string. Continue. All right, headers. Got headers with a bearer token, and we got the value in USD here. 6885, that is correct from the order. So I think this is where it's breaking down, and literally we're getting an unprocessable entity. What I can do. You know, I think this is correct. And this is just defined up here. I don't see anything wrong with that. We got a 201 response. That's what I'm seeing the PayPal side of things. So I believe, yes, we're good here. We return this response. Which is essentially the URL up to be. Response. Right. How can I inspect this a little bit better? ID created, method. The status created is what we're after. where it may be breaking down, then is back in the client. Process.js. We're not doing anything here. This is what I don't understand then. Oh, it's just, it is 500 because I didn't get any server error here. Huh. This is all working, I mean, unless it's throwing a 500. Weird. Parsing error. There we go. go to my credentials. And this is the personal user. Then we will do this. Yeah, very good. Okay. Strangely, so it's already captured even. Okay. So without this, it was able to capture the payment. Not really sure why. I don't think this is going to work now. I guess it was idempotent. Interesting. Let's try it one more time. Yeah, let's see what happens. Make a bookstore order. Yeah, well, a few of these items here. Hey. Check out. So we got a purchaser. Payment. So I don't have anything yet. I can't show this on stream, the PayPal log. There's a little bit of private information there. Let's pay with our credit union this time. Buy now, pay later. Ooh. Payment was successful. Holy mackerel. Did we get a capture? It's just super confusing when the capture was called. Yeah. Well, I'll assume it was a fluke, and I will then call the capture URL on approval. Check our capture view. Yeah, because I hadn't done any of that. Yeah, and our cart's getting cleared out, so that was a nice bonus. Still debugging, so I will walk through this server code. Yeah. Well, that's a helpful, helpful error. Let's try it again. All quiet on the Western Front. Okay, now we are into the view. Got a WSGI request. We're parsed. We've parsed the body. We've got the PayPal order ID. Camel case as JavaScript conventionally uses. Whoops. So we got this. Going to dive into the function. We've got our header. Not yet, but we have a PayPal order ID came in as a string. We have constructed the headers with the bearer token. We are making the request, getting a response, 201, successful. And we are going to raise for status, which should just be a no op. We get the order ID back, parse that correctly. It does indeed have an order ID property. Looks good to me. So our views are all working correctly up to there. And this is the prototype. I could probably store the PayPal payment ID here on the order itself. Let me think for 1 second. I've got the PayPal order ID, but you know, we might want to have a reference to that payment ID as well. So at this point, I believe I have this payment ID. However, response, we're getting it to the client. It's just a matter I think our default status is 200. Yeah. But that said, can I initialize it with a status? It's not actually change it, how to set the. I think I will use the status to, well, and I want a 201 status. Created. What does PayPal return? Let me just check their status. I can just return that. Because the order's already been created, and now it's like 201. We're completing it or something? Paying now, yeah. PayPal response is 201. Status code. Next one will be correct. Let's try one more time. Oh, there we go. Check the API logs. Two oh one capture success. Yeah, 1 minute ago, 30 seconds ago. 201 checkout order. Yeah, 5 seconds between them. Debug ID. Do we have some activity over here? I just don't understand this. I just don't understand this part of it. Yeah, it's actually showing up here. All right. Let's do one more end-to-end. A big one. All the books. Something like this. Buy them for my friends. Order ID. I gotta pay these from my credit card. Yeah. Waiting. Yes. Oh man. Yes, very good. So a little bit of cleanup. I'm gonna take a quick break, clean these up, commit, push. I'm going to attach the, see if the payment ID is there. I didn't actually check there. I should have done that. And if so, I can attach that to the order as well. So we have that metadata in the back end. But I need to take a quick break. I'll be right back. Make sure the cart has these methods. Okay, something stopped working there. This I need to double check. That I can clean up. I'm no longer using that. Payment views. Clean that up. Clean the brain tree up. Don't really need that. Granted. Can't fully remove brain tree yet. So once we get this, these subscriptions ported over, it'll be looking good. And a donation is a form of subscription so that it can be recurring. At least we have some donations that are subscriptions, some that are orders. It's a bit of a pain. Yeah, so all of this basically payment processing stuff, the specific provider stuff is going to move out of this. So Braintree, all that, it'll move into a PayPal module. But I'll have to do another day. This has been already a big battle. Not using cart anymore because we're clearing that out elsewhere. But that'll be the same pattern here where we remove all the payment processor stuff out of the view. And like into, I don't know how it'll work with the subscription because this is processing an order payment. Yeah. Have to come back to it with a fresh mind. Holy Casti, are there any other unused imports? Nope. Yeah, let's take a quick look at this create. There's a bug there, and then I'll call it good for the evening. So when I create an order, magazine books, oh gosh, man. There we go. Yeah, we'll just create one here. So we get to the create order page, and we've got these empty values. Something's up with the cart. I just need to check the cart interface. Add, say, remove, get cart products, get total cost, get subtotal cost. I put a couple of debuggers here. Get shipping cost. Shipping cost is coming through. So that's good to go. But it could be, am I just not calling to write? It's not the case. All right, continue. That is weird, because it didn't even call those methods. Doesn't quite make sense. Save that. All right. Yeah. Yeah, and let me just fix that little button here. This is kind of awkward. Quantity button. So basically, Bootstrap 5 got a bit simpler with how we define things. Input can be unterminated. And I just need to... And they're using Aria. The magic. This is really cool. Ah, but it's a button. It's a button. See if it works. It does. Okay. Good. All right. Ooh, I'm getting tired. 3 hours. Pushing this up. The test will be failing still, but the pull request is the same. PR number 907. So far, I've been focusing on the bookstore. But I think this is sort of an all or nothing work. Either I need to switch it over to PayPal or fall back to Braintree. I can't do half or half, and if for whatever reason there's a major setback in doing the PayPal subscription payments, we'd have to discuss whether or not PayPal is going to be the right solution for this project. But so far, I mean, yeah, we're going forward or backwards to PayPal or whatever direction we're moving towards PayPal. I just, you know, even based on this today's work, it was so challenging. I'm not really confident that PayPal will be the right solution for the subscription. It probably will be. I just don't know until I try. So I'm going to roll. This is going to be a big pull request. And there's some pep. Some lint stuff. Let's just clean that up real quick. Our settings pie. And our order views. In our PayPal. I don't know what else to call that. PayPal. And that is it. Yeah, the code quality in this pull request is also diminishing. I'll have to check out these Sonar Cloud notices to see what it's recommending. Going to need to make the tests pass, write new tests, delete possibly some old ones. The Braintree related stuff will need PayPal tests. It's going to be a big effort. Another probably week at least before I can get this calendar week, at least before I can get this kind of shaped up. But all right, made some progress today. Thanks for checking out this live stream. If you'd like to get involved with this project, you can check out the source code at github.com/westernfriend, and we're in the WF website project. We do have a lot of issues where we could use a little bit of help. A lot of these are just changes to templates or CSS. This one's been done. But you can see, and then we have some just lint and code quality issues that are usually pretty small. Even some of them are probably already even done and just haven't been closed. So yeah, hope you're doing well and enjoying the opportunity to be creative and make something that's interesting to you. And maybe we'll see you around on the stream. Have a great day.